last week I was at the tarot card course, and I'm with this esoteric school that is called the Phoenix Fellowship, and they have their own tarot cards. And last year this drawing next to me here I made in 2015, and you can see the big Mercury with the sun in the middle and this 8-pointed star with the G inside. And it was all like I was in this enormous transformation process, and I had actually no idea. Yeah, I know why I made this drawing. It was pure an intuition, but I had some knowledge with the symbols and some feeling why I wanted to make this drawing. But also a lot of stuff in the drawing is like, yeah, it was like a bit like a mystery for me. I had no idea, you know. And it was transformation. You can see the butterfly here with the flower, so big transformation. And this Mercury symbol is actually like the same like in Greek mythology. It's Hermes Trismegistus, and you know, he has the power over all the worlds. And I know Hermes could travel even into hell, at own will, and come back, and he's the messengers of the gods, you know. And but you know, I was a long time already busy with Hermes and with Mercury, but I had no idea actually how deep it went after like last week that I find out about all these drawings I made. That it's like one big story about how Mercury is evolving together with Venus. And now I got, every time I got from the tarot cards, I got this card number 21, and it says virtuosity. And 3 weeks ago I actually never heard of the word virtuosity, but now I know what it means, and it stands for extreme high skills in something, with a strong form of expression. And normally they use it for musicians, for people that work in arts and things like that. At least I got this card number 21, and you see all the colors of the rainbow. That's what I make always, all the colors of the rainbow in my drawings and my arts. And it's like a mystery how this evolves. And now I'm busy on drawing 21. I was already busy on this drawing, starting on this drawing like far before the course started. And not long ago I had to put, like, because I make 777 in the drawing, so 3 times 7 is 21, and my birthday is on number 12, so I always put like my name first letters G. So my innermost calls itself G, and I make like always G12 and stuff with 12, you know. And now I had to change like from 12 to 21. And then I was at the tarot course, and what does this teacher? He starts to explain everything about all cards. And at the tarot card, because I was already getting this card already for many times here, and I ask also about if I want to meet my twin flame, what do I need to do for to meet my twin flame? And I get every time this card, every time it falls out, and or I pick this card. And then the teacher at the course, we had to pick also a card, and I picked this card again last Saturday. And then the teacher writes really big on the board, like this. I put it down, like, well, you cannot see it. He put like 12, and then a circle, and then 21. And then he starts to explain about the card virtuosity, because I picked out the card. And the first card is mastery. And then he said like mastery is 1, and the second card is mystery. So from mastery you go into mystery, so from 1 you go into 2. But he said then it had to do something with card 11, and that was, what was card? I think it was harmony. Yeah, harmony. And then that has everything to do with coming together, not have to do everything alone, but it stands also for a union and marriage. And from card number 11, you come in card number 12. And that is transformation. So with 11, you're exactly on half. Yeah, because there are 21 cards. So you have to pick out, this is exactly the middle of the tarot deck. And then after is number 12, is transformation. And transformation, 12, is of course, the other side is 21. 1, 2, 2, 1. And how did he explain that? Yeah, from card number 1, you come in card number 2. That makes together card number 12. And then from card number 21, 12 you go to 21. But actually, then you go back. You go from 2 back to 1. That's how he explained it. So it was all very funny how you explained that. But why did he all say that? It is because when I came back home, I picked this card every time again, every time again. And I was still a little bit insecure about some things. So I was asking like, okay, is there really someone for me? And I had to stop asking that kind of stuff, you know. And then I got straight away this card, illusion. And I was like, why illusion, you know? So I started to worry. And I was like, okay, what now? And then I asked my Divine Mother, because I picked the Mother card also. Just gonna quickly, because this tarot deck is really beautiful. No. Where is she? Oh yeah. I picked out the Mother card, and then I had to channel with the Mother. So I channeled with the Mother, and the Mother, she told me like, hey, there is someone for you, but you have to stop behaving like this. You have to get more mature, you know. And if you want to track this really beautiful woman with this beautiful energy with your twin flame, then you should stop worrying about that, because you worry in a low vibration, and this is the low vibration, that's illusion, you know. This is what you attract when you keep worrying. And then she said, okay, you pick the cards again, you see, you get something different if your attention will be different. So okay, I put the cards again, and then I picked out first the Mastery card, and this is the Mastery card. And then I picked out this card, Eternity. So, but then I had to still pick another card, because I can feel really the cards. I get some energy going here, and then it goes here. And then when I don't need to pick the card, the energy goes woo down. But when the card is for me, it goes like woo. So it's really funny. This started actually like last week. Really funny. And there was one card I still had to pick out. So I picked first the Mastery card, then the Eternity card, and I felt another card. And again, I picked the Illusion card. But then I put them in front of me, and they were like all laying down, like the three of them, like this. And then I saw what it was. Like, you have to master this whole thing, this worrying that I do about this relationship. Because, yeah, if you have been on your path for 7 years already, then there is gonna be a moment that you get like, oh, I get so tired of this whole story, and is this real, or am I really mad? Even with all the drawings I make and all the transformations that I get and whatever, you know, you start to think, is this all real? And then she showed me like, okay, on one side you have like the Mastery card, and you can go both ways. You can start worrying or keep on worrying. Yeah, you will never attract your relationship, your twin flame. Because this is not the, how you say that, the right energy for that. Worrying will get you every time into illusions. If you keep on going like you're doing now, or you stop worrying and you go on like transforming every time you do now, you come in eternity. And there is what you are searching for. So that was really beautiful. And how do I get there? By emerge, really transform into something completely different. And that's how I get into virtuosity, because that is what will attract my relationship, my twin flame. I have to get into this. And this is all, yeah, if you see the last art that I make, and you look at the top here, where you can see it is 777, you can see this is really what I'm looking for. So now I have said that, then I ask again, like, okay, because yesterday I had like a very half good day, really beautiful high energy, and the other half of the day it broke down again, and I was like feeling not so good anymore. And then I asked the cards, like, okay, what can you tell me a little bit more for my direction, whatever, you know? And then they told me, like, yeah, you're in a struggle. So this is like a pyramid pointing up, and this is a pyramid pointing down. So you have good things, you see the sun here, and down you see the moon here, and this goes up and down, up and down. And they said, like, okay, if you want to get into virtuosity, you have to go through struggles, you have to go to a big heavy real revolution, and that's how you get to into emerge and into virtuosity. So that's what it is. And yeah, that's what I have to do. And I don't know what it is. Then they say trust and do your work and follow your path. I have something about Hermes, like in my other art you can see the rivers of Eden, like in this art here, like this eight here with the world here, and you got like the eclipse, the sun and the moon, when the masculine and feminine come together. It's actually like the solar and the lunar energies are coming together. You can see here Azot, and that's the big power of Kundalini. And these are actually the seven bodies. These are the seven chakras. This is the Sunbow, but this is also the rivers of Eden. And the rivers of Eden in the Kabbalah, they start with Yasod. And Yasod is the entrance. And you can see this streaming go up the way. And here down I have Mercury, and here I have the symbol of Venus. So this was the first time that Venus and Mercury came together. And it says, like, abuse of the sacred waters of Eden, Mercury can save all. The well is your body, the waters of life. You sought the lower waters of Eden, the lower Edens, that's how they call them. So the forces that you need to harness, are the sexual waters, the mental waters, the emotional waters, the spiritual waters, and the psychological waters. So when we do that, we can create the soul. Mercury, the god of speech, he delivers the word, the logos. And there are three types of Mercury. So you have the brute Mercury, the raw sexual energy. Then there is like the metallic soul of Mercury, that is transmuted sexual energy. And the fertilized Mercury, the Mercury of the wise. So that's where I am with this. With this knowledge, I have to make myself hermetically sealed. So I have to, yeah, start working on to let no energies go in or out again. For at least for, yeah, develop the mercury inside myself. And I have the feeling that I'm going from stage one to stage two now, from raw sexual energy to transmuted sexual energy. But I'm still at the, yeah, I have to work the last parts out before I get into the new stage. Now, since that I have, yeah, understood about the G, I have been wearing also clothes that I find, like a G-star and other kinds of clothes, everything that is with a G. And what I saw every time is G-star raw. So if I look at it now, you know, G-star raw is the raw sexual energy. And it was very funny last, or this year when I came back from Thailand, actually when I had overcome the first steps of the raw sexual energy, I gave away all my my G-star shirts with G-star raw on it, without actually thinking about this. But yeah, I was like, I wanted to have a change, and there were people from the village there that had not so much money, and yeah, from the mountain villages in high in Chiang Mai there, and I gave away all those clothes. So, and the, also something is that, like, last year I was working on a piece of art. Also before I went to Thailand, I got a really, really high energy for a couple of weeks, and I created, yeah, this big piece of art that is like piece number 19. Yeah, it was number 19, and that one is called Destiny. So this whole drawing was about the destiny that I was going for. And at that time, I was really listening a lot to there was a song, music from Vanessa May, the violinist, and yeah, this song was Destiny, and in this song they pronounce some words, and they say, like, Destiny, I will find you in my dreams, but also she says eternity waits. And then they say, from the pyramids of Egypt. So it is very funny, because I had some connection with Egypt already. Before I had from friends, they gave me from Egypt, a pyramid that I saved for many years. And I was flying from the Netherlands to Egypt, and from Egypt, from Cairo to Bangkok. And now I got this card because I just listened to this song again. I felt like listening to it again, and I didn't notice that because of the card Eternity, that Eternity waits in your destiny, and Eternity, I have to choose for Eternity to come into, Virtuosity will bring me into what I search for, Eternity in my dreams, you know. Just want to share that. It's just very funny. Okay.